In this video, we want to find out how to set a buy limit. Right now, you don't see it on the chart. But if you zoom in, you can see that we have this buy limit here below the current price. And now we are going to find out how to do that with MQL5. To do that, please click on the little button here or press F4 on your keyboard. Now you should see the MetaEditor window, and here you want to click on File, New, Expert Advisor from Template, Continue. I will call this file SimpleBuyLimit, click on Continue, Continue and Finish. Now we can delete everything above the OnTick function. Let's also remove the two command lines. We start by importing the file trade.mqh. This file comes with MQL5 and it includes a few trading functions. And we use it to create an instance of CTrade that will be called trade, and we are going to use it later on to open our buy limit. Inside of the onTick function, we start by getting the ask price. That is done by using SymbolInfoDouble. For the current symbol on the chart, we use symbol_ask, all in capital letters. And I like to use normalized double and underscore digits to automatically calculate the right number of digits behind the dot, because some currency pairs only have 3 digits behind the dot, while others have 5 digits. For this simple example, we are going to only check if we have open orders or open positions. In MQL5, we do that by using two different functions. The first one is orders total. That one will deliver the number of open orders that could become a position. The second one is for the positions that we have created. And only if both conditions are true, we are going to set our buy limit. That's done by using trade.BuyLimit. We need to pass a few parameters here in round braces. I always do both braces at the same time, so I don't forget one. And if you mark one of the braces here, you will see that the other one is highlighted in gray. That's a good way to find out if you have any errors here. The first parameter is for the lot size. We want to set the buy limit for a 10 micro lot trade. Parameter 2 is used to tell MetaTrader the price for the buy limit. We would like to get the current ask price and place our buy limit 200 points below the ask price. We use underscore symbol to automatically get the symbol on the chart. The next parameter would be for the stop loss. I don't use it here, but if you would like to use it, you can say something like ask minus 400 points. But I do use a value for the take profit. I would like to take the profit when the price rises 200 points above the current ask price. The next parameter, order time GTC, all in capital letters, is used for the expiration date. GTC stands for good to cancel. We don't have any expiration date here. So let's set the next parameter to 0. That would be the expiration time. Finally, we have one last parameter that is set to null, all capital letters. We could use it to pass a command that might be helpful if you are going to use several expert advisors on one and the same chart. But for this simple example, that's it. Let's click on the compile button or press F7. Oh, we missed a semicolon that needs to be placed behind the closing round brace here. Because you could write all these code lines here in a single line and the semicolon is the end of the statement. So let's recompile. And this time it worked without any errors and we also don't have any warnings. So now we can click here or press F4 to go back to MetaTrader. And in MetaTrader, we click on View, Strategy Tester, or press Ctrl and R. Please pick the new file, simplebylimit.ex5, Enable the visualization here and start a test. And now you should see that we have an entry for a buy limit for 10 micro lots. And if you click on the chart and press the minus key on your keyboard, you should see the buy limit here. Let's speed the process up and we should see a buy trade right here. Our buy limit was executed. We now have a buy trade. It wasn't executed here. That's because of the spread. And now you know how to create an expert advisor to place an automated buy limit below the current ask price. And you have coded it yourself with a few lines of MQL5 code.